Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. Thank you for joining the Rock Your Profile workshop. My name is Grace Mullen, and I am an agricultural account manager with RBC Royal Bank. I have been in my role for almost 3 years now. I am one of the Future Launch Champions facilitating sessions such as this one all year round. I'm excited to be here with you all today. Just a few housekeeping items. To preserve bandwidth, you are all muted and your videos have been turned on. However, if you have any questions, feel free to use the chat feature to ask your question as we roll along into the presentation. Another note, just a friendly reminder that RBC will not be recording this session, and I ask for all of you to refrain from recording the session planned today or taking any photos of participants appearing in the webinar. Thank you very much. Things may feel like they have come to a standstill, but learning and connecting can continue still with RBC Future Launch at Home. In addition to creating virtual workshops like the one you are participating in today, we have created RBC Future Launch at Home, which allows you to easily navigate through our partner-hosted virtual skill development workshops, online learning modules, and mental well-being supports and services. You can easily access diverse virtual learning and mental well-being resources all in one place, helping you to nurture your mental well-being, improve your creative career and life skills, and keep connected. Virtual learning and mental well-being resources to help you stay alive and stay ready can be found at www.rbc.com/future-launch-at-home. We will also place this link in the chat box for you to view at a later date. So who's on LinkedIn today? What's been your experience so far? I know for myself, I have had employers in the past message me directly after reviewing my profile to discuss further opportunities they may have. So that's an excellent segue into the fact that, as we know today, most recruiters, talent acquisition specialists, hiring managers, and HR professionals are looking to LinkedIn to learn more about you beyond your traditional resume or CV. So what does your LinkedIn profile say about you? What do you want it to say about you? How do you want potential employers to view you and your brand? Knowing that you need to stand out as an applicant in order to make that transition from applicant to viable candidate, you can't just think of LinkedIn as a place to copy and paste your resume. LinkedIn is the best social media platform to not be afraid to be your true authentic self. So what can you make? So how can you make it meaningful connections? Your authentic LinkedIn profile will help you start those conversations that will go on to help build your knowledge, network, and impact. And just a few facts there that you'll see on the screen. 95% Fortune 500 companies use LinkedIn for recruiting and sourcing talent. Over 300,000 companies, including small businesses, formally find talent on LinkedIn. 1.4 million recruiters are actively using LinkedIn to find and engage talent. 70% of people were hired at a company where they had a connection. 85% of employers say a positive online reputation influences their hiring decisions. So today we're going to cover the following items. We're going to go through, today we will review how to build your LinkedIn profile, how to build that professional network, how to use that network to connect to opportunities, and lastly, how to find jobs on LinkedIn. And once again, should you have any questions, feel free to insert them in the chat and I will answer them as we roll along. So LinkedIn's vision is to create economic opportunity for every member of the global workforce. There are over 170,000 new members daily, and 637 new data points are created every 2 seconds. This data enables you to be more successful on your career journey. In Canada, there are over 17 million members on LinkedIn exploring over 300,000 companies and 400,000 jobs. Through LinkedIn Learning, there are over 16,000 courses to help you with your skill building. RBC held a survey back in July 2020, and we learned that almost half, 49% of the youth surveyed cited professional opportunities being canceled due to COVID-19 as a challenge they are facing in preparing for their professional future, followed by feeling unmotivated. 37% of youth surveyed are not sure what resources and opportunities are available to them. And one of the most common questions we hear at workshops and events is, how do I maintain connections in a virtual world? That's why we recommend leveraging LinkedIn as a virtual solution to help you connect with jobs, people, and skill development opportunities, especially when we can't connect in person. So the goal is to show who is on LinkedIn and the hiring activities on LinkedIn. For job seekers to understand that if they didn't use LinkedIn to apply for a job, the hiring manager or recruiter will most likely still go on LinkedIn and view their profile before deciding to interview them. And as you'll see there, 2.5 million people on LinkedIn are hired through their connections every year. Don't just apply to jobs, connect to jobs on LinkedIn. Regardless of how the hiring manager first learns about you, most likely they are checking out your LinkedIn profile before deciding to bring you for an interview. And I'm now going to we're going to play a short video. So if you'll bear with me here.
Come out here on the grind, I was not gonna get a job. I would wake up at 6 a.m. every morning. I sent out probably 25 emails a day on LinkedIn to schedule coffee with people I thought were interesting. Probably had 6 to 7 meetings for about 2 months. 7 cups of coffee a day is far too much caffeine for anybody. When I went to these coffee meetings, I never once asked for a job. I strictly said, do you mind just sprinkling tidbits of knowledge for me? During that time, a lot of the rejection I faced was I would go to these meetings and these people wouldn't even show up. Rejection's inevitable, but all it takes is one.
This guy knew what he wanted, knew what he wanted to do, and took that step.
About a week later, Houston gave me a call and said, hey, I have a contracting role, would you be interested in it? So I did that for a bit. Eventually that evolved. He's like, hey Rahul, let's go out for a walk and talk. And I was like, oh man, he's about to fire me. During that walk, he said, you know, we'd like to offer you full time. I was like, this is awesome.
You know, now that he's kind of my right-hand man, it's been an amazing journey.
LinkedIn facilitated a lot of the connections I made and the connections I would not have ever made had I not had a tool like that.
So now that we know what LinkedIn can do for you, let's explore. First, we're going to start with developing your professional brand and voice. During this segment, we will cover off what you need to help you get started. We will talk about the key differences between a resume and your LinkedIn profile. We'll give you some profile photo tips and cover off how to edit your profile. And lastly, tips on how to develop your professional voice. Your passions and values are the underlying themes that drive your professional and personal decisions. In order to make you stand out as authentic and call attention to what makes you unique, it is done by telling your story. Your story is your brand, and it shows how you got to where you are today. Share your experiences, promote your passions, highlight your transferable skills, and if done correctly, it captures the essence of your brand. Employers are looking for more than credentials. More and more, they are looking for demonstrations of your competencies, so your skills, your knowledge, your attitude. That's one of the reasons why getting direct workplace exposure and experience is so important. It's also why you need to think about competency development, not just credential accumulation. Instead of just relying on traditional resume, think about giving yourself a leading edge by creating an experience or a competency portfolio where you can record the competencies you develop every time you learn or work. For example, if you successfully led a project team for school assignment, this is just an example of a project management in action. If you handled a store or restaurant on your own because a colleague phoned in sick, this is an example of the ability to thrive in a fast-paced environment and problem-solving skills. With a portfolio which can be developed using a binder or an online portfolio website, not only can you talk about your skills, but you can also point to real examples of how you have demonstrated them. So getting prepared before working on your LinkedIn profile will be extremely helpful. Ask yourself, what are my interests? And jot down a few items. Is it design, gaming, finance, cooking? What about values? Try completing the sentence. I value. Examples may include integrity, health, family, peace. Now think about your abilities. Ask yourself, what am I good at? Examples include singing, selling, repairing, public speaking, working with others. You should also think about your qualities. So what qualities do you see in yourself? Are you determined, active, a leader, patient, or just some examples? This may be the hardest part of creating your profile, but it will definitely help you if you have at least three interests, values, and abilities and qualities jotted down. If you do need more support in learning more about you, we recommend you visiting our RBC Launching Careers website, which we will also have that link in the chat box for you. And just to note, it is www.rbc.com/launching careers. There are many exercises included to help you articulate key characteristics about you on that portal. Some other items you may want to gather before working on your profile: a photo of yourself, past resumes and cover letters, any skills, tools, results you may have done in the past, your credentials, volunteer roles, and don't forget your reward, your awards and accomplishments if you have them. So you may hear that your profile is similar to a resume, but there are big differences between your LinkedIn profile and your resume. Your LinkedIn profile will speak to all potential employers, not just a single one, and goes into much more detail with skills, projects, interests, certification, and more. Your profile allows other professionals and employers to interact, learn, and contact you. Lastly, it includes recommendations and endorsements you can obtain from your connections. I find that my LinkedIn profile, once complete, helps me build my resume and cover letter, and at times can help me prepare for that big interview. So, how to take a great photo. First, you need to select a photo. Look to get this done professionally if possible. If not, you can do wonders with the portrait mode on any phone. Do not use a photo with others in it, as it should simply be you in a clear, viewable photo. If you do not use a photo with others, be sure to crop it properly and view it on all devices. You may be surprised to see your significant other was not cropped for that iPhone, even though it looked great on your computer. Now, next, your headline. Your headline is an opportunity to show what you are, not just what you do. Creating an interesting and compelling header statement, this is where you come alive. Use this space to grab your reader's attention to say that they want to know about you. You are marketing yourself. Think about the audience you want to attract. Ask yourself, if you were scrolling through a LinkedIn profile, would you come across your profile? Would you be compelled to click on it and to find out more? And as you'll see there on the screen, I'll just kind of go through that. So when you're writing your headline, ask yourself, is this the only thing someone sees? What does it say about me? Does this represent my professional brand and show I am unique? Does it capture what a recruiter would care about? So how many of you read a person's summary section and were left uninspired or maybe stopped reading altogether because it felt like a resume summary and kind of bland? Talk in first person so that it is authentic to your reader. If this is about you, then you need to make it about you. Have fun with your journey and all that you have done. Highlight those moments and times that you are most proud of and make it loud and clear. And just a key tip, make sure to include a summary of at least 40 words to show up in the search results of other members. So you want to include about 1 to 2 sentences about who you are, 3 to 5 sentences about your experience, top skills and key passions, and then finally 1 to 2 sentences about your future goals and how other members can engage with you. All right, so by clicking on the Me icon at the top of your LinkedIn homepage and then clicking on Add New Profile section, you'll be able to add your location and industry, education and certifications, work, internship, and volunteer experience, your skills, programs or organizations, and recommendations. Now that we've talked about your profile, let's cover how you can connect with the professional world. So building your professional network, discovering existing and searching for new connections and tips on how to expand your network. Did you know 50% of new hires result from a personal connection? LinkedIn members are 4 times more likely to get hired when referred. Can anyone in the room name someone who is in their network? And I will allow a few minutes for you to type that into the chat if you feel comfortable doing so. And if not, I'll just speak from my experience there. So some of my people in my primary network, I would consider to be those that I work with. So it could be those that also work at RBC, likely my vice president, so my manager, my direct manager. So everyone has a network. So you may not realize it. Networking occurs every time you meet new friends or acquaintances, volunteer in your community, or through any social activity, such as participating in a LinkedIn coaches workshop. Networking is a key factor in a career advancement. In fact, over 50% of workers currently employed found their job through a personal connection. Your network consists of strong connections, the people you know well and interact with often, as well as weak connections, so acquaintances or people you may not know personally, but have shared background, interests, or mutual connection in common with. On LinkedIn, your first degree connections are people already in your network. Your second degree connections are people you share a connection with, while your third degree connections are connected to your second degree connections. Research shows that your weak connections, those originally in your second and third degree networks, are often more valuable for your job search than strong existing connections because their networks are more diverse than your own. For example, my neighbor's sister works at Amazon. I've only met her once, but if I want to work at Amazon, she can help me find jobs there and connect me with people in my field. Each time you connect with someone new, their extended network becomes more accessible to you. On LinkedIn, you can connect with people you have something in common with, or with people who have a job or work at a company that interests you. Also, you can connect with people who may be able to connect you to someone who can help you achieve your goal. When I've reached out to someone, I typically include who I am, how I found their profile, how I can help that person, and perhaps how they can help me. People are busy, so you really want to get to the point. but in a professional, friendly manner. And I just make the note there that the chat function is not currently working, only the Q&A function. So that is where you are to place your questions should you have any. You'd be surprised at how many existing connections you can uncover. Click on the My Network in the top navigation to find people like family and friends, current and former colleagues and managers. I've noticed that the recommendations under people you may know keeps getting smarter the more I use the platform. It's super easy to find new connections by leveraging the search function. I can use search to look for a name, company, location, keyword, and alumni. What would I search for if I'm interested in communications position at RBC in Vancouver? So for instance, I might search up RBC, I might search Vancouver to help me discover that position. On LinkedIn, you can customize your connection request to explain why you are interested in adding a second or a third degree connection to your network, whether it is to learn about their career journey through an informal interview or to request a referral for a job you're interested in. Most LinkedIn members often or always respond to a request for a referral, and more than 60% of the workforce has referred someone to work at their company. While it can feel uncomfortable or nerve-wracking to connect with someone new for this purpose, it really is a professional norm that just might lead to your career opportunity. Have confidence and be realistic. There will be times that someone may not connect with you for a number of different factors. Don't take it personal, just move on. Joining groups can be a great tool as well to give and get career help and resource. Consider groups in your industry or alumni of your school or a training program. Once you've got your network, feel free to message your connections, ask for informal virtual coffee shop chats, request referrals from people you know. You can reach out to past boss or a colleague for a recommendation, and remember, add value, engage, and have fun. You may be asking, how do I add value? I'm just starting my career. But you can add value in many ways, whatever stage of your career you may be in. Invest time in your connections, and as mentioned, request virtual coffee chats. Like and share things that people in your network will care about and post. Join groups and exchange insights with school or program alumni, and give testimonials and recommendations to people you've connected with in the past. Here's an example of how to ask someone for information interview. Of course, at this time, you'd be asking for a virtual connection, but start off with a message including who you are and how that connection can help you. So you'll see there on the screen, hi, Erin, I'm currently exploring careers in communications and I admire your experience and accomplishments in the industry. I'd appreciate the opportunity to hear about your career. Would you be available for a 20-minute chat over the phone or in person the next few weeks? I look forward to hearing from you. Okay. So as you can see there, clean, short, to the point, and there's value by that person acknowledging that they have some experience that they're interested in learning more about. Now, lastly, here's an example of how you can request a referral. Make sure you include why you are interested in the specific role, your appreciation for your connections consideration. So we see there, hi, Seth, hope you're doing well. I saw that SixX is hiring communication specialists, and I'm very interested in applying. This role seems like a great fit for me because it needs self-starter who can operate within a complex environment. Would you be willing to share any information on the position, the team, and what they might be looking for in a candidate? I'd be greatly appreciative. Let me know if you have any questions about my experience as it relates to this role. All the best, Kate. So as you can see there, it is clear to the point of why this person is interested in that specific role, as well as the appreciation that they have for considering making that connection. Now, let's talk about staying informed. Stay connected to the companies that matter most to you by following them. You can do this by following the company's page. So simply search for them under companies in the search box. Following a company helps you stay on top of news, trends, and new product launches for that company. And in addition, following companies, you can gain insight by following those LinkedIn influencers. So follow industry influencers to stay on top of key trends, topics, and insights from the people you respect and admire. When you follow an influencer, you can see their activity across LinkedIn in the feed. In addition to gaining industry insights and staying informed on what matters to you, you can also leverage LinkedIn to find what you care about. So leveraging the skills, interests, values that we discussed earlier in the workshop, use the search function to find content, stay informed to the things that are important to you. So we're coming to the end of the workshop, but we'd like to share information on getting hired and building your career. So find where you want to work and discover who works there before you apply for a job. Did you know that there are over 30 million employers and 20 million monthly job postings on LinkedIn? That's quite a bit. So get the LinkedIn search app, set career interests, search for jobs, review jobs you may be interested in, use your network, follow companies, and lastly, apply actively. Let employers and recruiters know you're actively looking for a job by setting yourself as an open candidate and updating your career interests. The LinkedIn Job Search mobile app has additional tools to help you stay on top of your job search. For example, get notified when your application has been viewed, a saved job is about to expire, or when there are new jobs that meet your search criteria. When searching for jobs, search by keyword, job title, company, location, function, industry, experience level, and date posted using LinkedIn search filters. Review your daily jobs you may be interested in by clicking on the jobs icon in the top navigation. Based on your job preferences, profile, companies you follow, network, interests, and other activities on LinkedIn, the more you use LinkedIn, the more accurate job recommendations you will receive. Referrals are a great way to get your foot in the door. If you have a connection at a company you would like to work for, ask them for an introduction or for a referral. On each job posting, you'll see either the Easy Apply or Apply on Company website button to apply for the job. To apply for jobs on the go, use the LinkedIn Job Search mobile app. So to recap, we covered off quite a bit in a very short amount of time today. So we'll go over building your profile that promotes your brand, expanding your network, sharing with your network and learning from others, setting career interests and job alerts. I will now just pause for a minute and allow anyone to ask any questions within the Q&A chat before I end with my closing remarks. All right, so I just had one question there. That was very informative. Will your presentation be available on the posted website? Thanks. Yes, it will be. Thank you for that feedback. Oh, great. We have one question there. Any specific advice for business profiles? Oh, that's a good one. So just to kind of clarify, you must be a business owner, I'm thinking, and you have some questions in regards to advice. I think the big one is to position your business as as welcoming as possible, as you do want candidates to be searching your site and to be interested in your business. So showcasing the culture, the positives, I think would definitely help with people visiting your page. All right, another question here. For brands, do you recommend LinkedIn in ads? Yes, definitely. Get your brand out there. All right, I'll give it a couple more minutes if you have any other questions for me. Looks like we have one more coming. As a student who is working towards building a portfolio, what should my main focus be in order to do so? That's a great question. So I think your main focus should be kind of going back to the start of the presentation there, is really focusing on various organizations maybe you worked with, that personal brand, what you bring to the table, what inspires you, what you admire, what you want people to see about you. Network with many organizations. Don't be shy to introduce yourself online, to make connections. I can definitely go a long way. Awesome. So just to conclude there, your LinkedIn profile is only one of the puzzle pieces in your career journey. If you're interested in learning more about how you can navigate and manage your career, regardless of the field you want to be in, check out our Launching Careers Playbook at www.rvc.com/launching careers. We will also insert that into the Q&A section for you to access, as well as future launch sites at www.rvc.com/future launch. We will include that site as well for more tools and resources on how you can kickstart your career. I hope you had fun during this workshop and that we provided you with concrete tips, advice to help you rock your profile. Thank you so much for joining us. And we have some resources there you may be interested in.